someone's door.
He did suck on my finger the moment I met him.
You put your finger in my mouth.
Okay, what the fuck?
Yeah, imagine
you guys
that,
are free.
You ask your mate for help. You're locked in your apartment. No SIM card. Had a SIM card. Didn't know how to put it in my phone. This man rocks up, puts his finger in my mouth.
It's not true. I said, let's pound it. And he started sucking on my finger.
Yeah, let's pound it. And then he was like, oh, in my mouth.
Oh, my God. Okay.
Jesus Christ.
I'm on way too much cold and flu. Pounding my throat. You should be listening to this fucking conversation.
I don't want to. So I need to change it to my farming outfit.
Yeah, you got a farming outfit, Khaled? I need you to start farming.
Listen, brother, I've got PTSD from marijuana.
we're gonna need you to start growing carrots. They don't give a shit about carrots. Guess what? It's what your life is now.
Now a carrot farmer.
Yep. We need you to turn it into fertilizer.
It's either that or you just get a whole heap of dead bodies and fertilize them. Your choice.
Yeah.
Or you can go the other route, where you ain't got to grow it, but you got to sell it. You want to sell it?
Listen, fellas. Listen. Look at me.
Yeah, you're built for standing behind like some fucking shady-ass house slinging shit. You can't say that you're not.
I'm never putting another fucking seed in the ground.
Nobody's asking you to put a seed in the ground.
I'm just... Sir.
We did just tell him that he had to plant carrots.
Yeah.
Oh yeah, I forgot that happened. I thought we were past that.
Touch anything that grows from the ground ever again, unless it's in a fucking little plastic bag.
Huh.
And it's in my prison pocket, and I'm selling it on the street.
That's what they just offered you.
Yeah, that's why I said behind a shady house slinging.
Sell carrots and shit. But as long as I got a fucking gat.
No, we weren't talking about fucking selling carrots.
No, I know. You're talking about selling weed. Like, obviously.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah.
I mean, unless you got heroin, you know what I mean? I'll have a little taste.
He's fucked. He's cooked. Guy's going to end up using all of his money on product just for himself.
You've never shafted Shibu, obviously. Whatever.
I get coke blown up my ass by a straw, but I've never done heroin.
That is shafting Shibu.
That's coke, not heroin.
Shabu.
Yeah, but what's that second word?
It's just shafting Shibu.
That's okay. Maybe we should drop him off down to BBMC.
Probably be perfect down there, to be honest with you.
Yeah.
Listen.
Him and Dundee will get along well. Listen.
Kind of a big deal, guys. All right.
Right.
I'm impressing you with my presence here.
Oh, okay. Okay.
Yeah, I know people. You know what I mean?
Yeah. Name three.
Oh, in this room.
Oh, you want me to name three people like that I know? Well, I don't know if they're around, so I can't really drop names. You know what I mean?
All right.
I'm, you know what I mean, and I'm a secretive guy. I don't like to aerate. You know what I mean.
That
maybe you don't
like
know them.
Yeah.
If I don't know them, they're not important. Then, right? Got you there.
Sick.
Come on, you got to know somebody.
Listen, Draco Gelboy.
You said this 9 times. I don't know what the fuck that is.
Well, you look like Draco Malfoy. Got a fucking
who the fuck is
gel and just slapped it on his head like the guy from fucking Me, Myself, and Irene.
Mari, don't entertain him. That was ass.
What's up, Mike?
Hey, what's up? Zula told me to call.
I'm just waiting for a call from Ming to see how everything goes. So I'll give you a call once I finish that.
Right.
Uh-huh.
What happened? Did anything happen last wave? Like, was there more? Like, you know what I'm saying?
Yes. They robbed a fucking cellar, but that's it.
Did we do anything?
Well, no. That's what I'm saying. That's what we did.
Oh.
Yeah. Today they've been hunting, so just be careful, right?
Yeah, I mean, they were hunting yesterday. Everybody was yapping about how we were going to get them and get back in NA, but it's like, Ming, you know what I mean? Like the snake chasing its own tail, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah,
like the head and they're never awake at the same time, so you're never going to get your get back.
Yeah.
Anyway.
I'll talk to you in a bit.
Bye-bye.
Wait. Mark's around.
We need to talk with him.
I need to go to fucking bed. That's what I need.
Well, it'll only take 10 minutes after this.
You
gotta
fucking bed, cunt.
Well, you could just... We have to handle some business, cunt.
Oh, I don't need to handle shit. Cunt. My hours of operations are closed. Where the fuck is Carl?
Hey, Carl.
Where's Carl? Is that what you said?
Probably. Carl!
It's the weekend. Yeah.
Oh. KJ.
Yeah, you know something funny? You want to know something funny, Mari?
Wait.
What?
So, yeah, KJ is like, I'm always awake. I'm always here.
No, he's not. He's less than I am, and I'm barely here anymore.
Right? Right?
Amen, sister.
Who asked, Khaled?
For 2 days, and I've been around more than he has.
Is it because you've been around Billy? Because he's sick too. I blame Billy, especially since he's not here. Billy. I still can't believe he called himself Clapasaurus Rex. What the fuck is that name? Ming, please. Ming, please.
You do know he knighted somebody else in Polito to be in a gang called the Peepees, and he knighted him by placing his penis on his shoulder blade.
That really doesn't surprise me when it comes to Billy.
Yeah.
Billy reminds me of
lots of things. But wait.
I don't know if you know it. There used to be this really old TV show in Australia called Mr. Squiggle, the Man on the Moon.
Definitely not.
What was it called?
Mr. Squiggle.
Mr. Squiggle.
Man on the Moon. He's like the fucking
motherfucker.
He's the depressed fucking chalkboard who just says out-of-pocket shit out of nowhere.
Hurry up. That's what he always says. Hurry up. Maybe just learn how to fucking walk on him. What is Fiona doing now?
That actually looks pretty good, Khaled. You should stay like that.
She was roof running.
We found your job. You're a permanent... wall fixture.
God, I want to punch you right in the fucking dick right now.
Yeah. Well, then I'd take you to the work tribunal. I'll touch my dick.
What the fuck?
Take everything you got, motherfucker. You.
It's true. Not my employee.
If anything, technically, you're a trespasser and Reggie was standing his ground.
That's true, and that's how I'll spin it.
That's how, you know, we've got witnesses here.
This guy just ran in when I unlocked the door. I told him to get out several times. He didn't, and he started being all aggressive, so I punched the cunt.
He said, come to my house. I have a business opportunity for you.
Okay,
and then winked at me. And then
you know
punched
you
me in the dick.
If you're
actually fucked.
Opportunity like that, you should go to the third stall in the liquid library. Upstairs, liquid library bathroom in the third stall.
Yeah, I ain't walking into no liquid library.
Why not?
That sounds a lot of liquid.
I mean, in the third stall.
10 minutes! 10 minutes!
Okay, we've got topless dudes walking around behind me.
That's his farming outfit.
Yeah, he's just doing some farming.
Yeah, look, man, respect the haircut. You already know what it is.
Okay, for one, we've got a low wattage light here. Like, what's going on here? We're farming inside. Where's the fans? Come on, guys. Low airflow. Carbon monoxide isn't being produced in the soil. Like,
listen, how do you think they get fucking high on shit?
Yeah.
What about the lights? What about them? Yeah, I didn't finish decorating here. I got sidetracked doing something else. Fuck off.
Cool. Imagine fucking...
Listen. I hung them up with that fucking Invisalign. What of it, bitch?
Yeah.
Raz, thank you for the 22 months. What? It's just a visible wire. What are you talking about? Just a very thin wire.
Fishing string. Yeah. This has been the longest 10 minutes ever.
Right? It's been over 10 minutes, man.
Maybe we should meet up with Mike first. And then when they call, then we cut the meeting with Mike.
Get Mike to come here and then get him to bring food and drink.
Yeah, good point. Just get Mike to come here.
Can you get me a blicky just in case?
No.
Yeah, I'm serious. I then get him to come here and then bring some food and drink for me, and I'll give him money for it. The amount of times I've fed all those people up north, I damn well.
And of course, guess what? Mike's on the farm.
Of course he is.
My fucking throwing knife.
What the fuck?
Huh? Fuck around, you get the pointy end.
Can you actually throw it?
Well, yes. Of course you can.
Wanna find out?
Oh, throw it at Brandon.
Why would I throw it at Brandon? Just throw it at you.
They're standing behind me. Get the fuck away from me, man.
Throw it, bro.
What, you think you got some fast footwork there, mate? Huh?
Moves like Jagger. I will knock you the fuck out, man.
Look at me, look at me. Oh, I can't fucking do it, I'm too sick.
When I try to jump on your head.
Yeah, cool.
10 minutes. You know what? I should just go to bed and be like, you know what? Fuck this problem. Not my issue.
Well, shall we talk with Mike and then, yeah.
Yeah, we'll just tell him to come here.
I am, but he's fucking on the phone, so.
Did you tell him to call you?
He just got a missed call from me, so we'll see.
Just message him and say, call me.
His phone will notify him of a missed call from me.
Mine doesn't do that.
I'm fucking pissed. I'm fucking pissed.
You're pissed? I'm an hour past my bedtime. I'm pissed.
God, you're a grumpy old fuck.
Yeah.
It's past his bedtime.
Yeah.
You want to go night-night, little boy?
Yeah. Technically, I'd be closing my eyes and flying to Russia. I'm bopping some heads.
What the fuck? People still do that shit?
Yeah.
Whatever happened to the other one?
This is my special time.
Yeah, whatever happened to that gray place?
Yeah, no, it's dead.
Damn, that's crazy that everybody bought that shit and then it's dead.
Yeah. Good times.
Okay. Wild.
I got my money back.
What was the reason everybody fucking dipped?
How do I explain it? You know, you can only get so far and do so many things and not have that much conflict, you know? Need both. I need to get that fucking heat out there, you know?
Are you saying it was boring?
He was trash at it, that's why.
Okay, well, that's not true. Well.
What?
But isn't the blue-haired bandit?
Definitely so, just lost cops at a BMX.
How you doing, Mike?
Is that why you said washed?
Yeah, because he taunted saying I look like Coral Star. So I taunted him saying wash because he couldn't catch me on a BMX, and then he talked shit on Twitter. Like, he didn't just lose me on a BMX, you know?
Yeah. Oh, also, Fiona. Mm-hmm? I need you to start thinking up of some names for the thing that we're working on. Start cooking.
Okay.
Because the best I've got right now is R&D.
Okay, that's not good.
did you say, Khalid?
Nothing.
He's on his way over here.
Well, so I just spoke to Future before. Mike's on his way. I spoke to Future and he said 10 minutes. It's been 20 minutes. I just want to go to bed.
I just want a shitlord.
The later it goes, the more fucking cooked I get, which then means that I get very fucking short fuse.
As opposed to...
Yes,
amen.
Yes.
Amen.
Yes, as opposed to what I currently have, yes.
Yeah. So, like, okay, how short does it get?
Extremely.
Like, make things worse?
Yeah.
Sick.
Yeah. Listen, I can only be the voice of reason for so long, and then I get grumpy, or I get hangry, and then all reason goes out the window.
Mm-hmm.
I'm a rational person when dealing with these things, yeah, and until a certain point when I get hangry or fucking tired.
We need to buy you food?
No.
Fool's on his way. Mike's bringing some.
Well, food generally stops you from being hangry.
Well, but then I just get angry. I got.
Maybe you need to get your chakras aligned, Reggie.
What?
You gonna meditate next to the wind chimes?
Fuck no!
Why?
Meditate?
You wanna sit over there by the wind
chimes?
You
will be cupping nothing around me.
Let Khalid just hum, you know, softly in the air while you do it.
You know, static. This dickhead, one, couldn't get out of his apartment, but two, it seemed to have shaved off his fucking eyebrows. Had to go fucking down to the barbers. I'm telling people.
Interesting.
Yep. Fuck yeah. So I had to trim a bit of hair off his fucking beard and put it on his eyebrows.
It's already started, and he's only an hour past his bedtime. This meeting needs to go fast.
Yeah.
I hope you get shot at this meeting.
You know what? Honestly, I kind of hope that I do too. I kind of hope that I do too. So then I can just slide into something comfortable like an ICU fucking bed. And then I don't need to wake up for a few days and I can just stay dreaming about Russia. Fuck it.
Here we go.
See, this is what happens when I start staying up too late. Fuck it. Fuck everything.
You might die, dumbass.
God! Then I don't need to worry about dealing with this shit.
Everyone else will still have to. Then we'll have no HR and then it'll just keep getting worse.
Yep. Well.
You're the only voice of reason here.
Yep. Well, you say I'll be dead. It won't be my problem.
That's true. You're not wrong. It won't be your problem.
And guess what? Billy's all your problem then.
No,
I die,
wrong.
Billy goes to you.
Nope, you're
what
not leaving
fuck?
Me Billy in your fucking will, motherfucker.
Yeah.
No.
Yep, you're stuck with him then for life.
What do you mean for life?
Yep.
How are you locked in with Billy for life?
I'm not really. It's a stipulation.
No, I'm not looking after Billy.
The only way you get rid of him is by killing him.
I'll do that.
I'm hearing one side of this conversation and it is very interesting.
By the way, it's whispering. Not Billy now, it's Clapasaurus Rex.
You missed that. That's Future.
What?
Oh.
Yo, you want to meet with us? We're ready to speak to you.
Okay, where do you want to meet?
I don't know. Where do you guys want to meet?
Nice scenic place. Where am I thinking?
Up at the observatory.
Observatory? Yeah, fuck it, that works.
All right, we'll see you there.
All right, bye.
All right.
Jaded!
Fucking Mike's here, outside the Blue House.
Well, we need to deal with this.
Yeah, I know. He could just hang out with Mari, give us some food or something, I guess.
We're going to the observatory, call Jaden, link up with him and work out where you just want to go.
Gotcha.
Bye.
All right.
Let me change my phones. Actually,
I need you to unlock the door.
Motherfuck.
How was good, Slime? You ready?
Bro. Good luck.
Mari, I'm putting my phone in the locker here.
Okay.
Thank you.
You know, being followed.
Don't worry about it right now. We just got the call.
Good luck.
Thank you.
Thank you.
All right, brother. I appreciate it.
Fiona, if you want, you can go with them. It's just with those three and then us two. So if you want to go with Jaden and them, you can.
What are they doing?
Watching over for me. If you want to help him, watch out. Just call Jaden.
Mike went all the way up to Polito, by the way. He went to the blue house in Polito.
Jaden, make sure you take Fiona with you too, please. And look after Khaled. Khaled, you stay with Jaden.
Get me out of the south side, please. It's like running through a fucking minefield.
Are you guys going?
Radio, what's the radio?
I don't have one. You think I'd be dumb enough to get a radio with you guys? Hello?
We don't have one. Come here.
Come down, bro. You guys sort out one between each other. Oh yeah, Khaled, come here. Yeah. Probably won't last long, but there you go.
What is that?
Radio.
Thank you for the channel.
Talk to them.
Cut the fucking attitude.
Well, I literally just said I'm not going to be on a fucking radio. Hello?
I'll just get taken, whip you out of that car and whip your ass.
Okay, you know I do shit. Where is Louie?
You know, they're going to show up all staggered and stuff. They're going to get spotted and shit.
Yeah, that's why I'm trying to sort this shit out now.
It's going to look like a fucking ambush on their end. They're going to freak out.
Blue head beetle looking guy just exploded.
Fiona, I've got my other phone number on Lemonless. Can you call me? Just so I have your other one. Thank you.
I think he had Bob.
Oh.
Are you coming here?
Yeah, I'm pulling up.
Okay. Jaden just had a headache. This is my burner number that I've got on me, alright?
Sounds good. I'm where Jaden was. I'm here.
Wait, where are you?
Pulling up in 2 seconds.
Right, motherfucker here. Says I'm here. Alright, you got Khaled and Fiona with you. Fiona, have you got a gun? Fiona, have you got a gun?
Not on me.
Where is it?
We can go get it.
I can get it.
Okay. Probably should grab that.
Get me one.
Well, we're unfortunately a little bit strapped for time now that Jaden's had a headache.
Yeah. Do you have a radio?
No, I'm not going to be on radio. Otherwise, you know, if something happens, then now you already automatically have that radio, you know?
Yeah. All right. I'm there going when Jaden comes back.
Carl is actually going to get run over. But yeah, sort out a radio between yourselves and try and work something out. Essentially, what you need to do is you just need to keep an eye on what you can. Don't get spotted. If anything goes down, then fucking react from there. But other than that, just be chill.
Yeah, sounds good.
Alright, just give me a call once you guys are ready for me to pull in.
Sounds good.
Alright, bye.
Alright. Fifi, you riding with us?
Yeah, you're all together.
Perfect, guys. Sounds good, guys. Radio 435.2.
If you can, try and get Carla a gun. Just make sure you take it off him afterwards. But yeah, you guys stay together.
Sounds good.
Alright, bye.
Yeah. Alright, bye.
They're probably already going to be there, and they're going to see them drive up.
Oh, they're just going to be smart. Fuck them. Listen, if I get shot and I get to fucking go to bed, I'm good. I'm already fucking an hour and 20 minutes past me bedtime. I even took my seatbelt off just then and I thought it was already off, but it's not. We're getting into the cook stages for me.
Yeah, we're gonna be fine.
No. It was like 4 hours ago I was told. What is happening? Bro's trying to fucking head on me. I was told like fucking 4 or 5 hours ago that 1 to 2 hours. You know, if I was smart, I would have told him to go strap up earlier.
Yeah. Now, the likelihood of all of them having a gun is going to be pretty fucking low. And if something does happen to us and they respond, hopefully they don't get fucking like 2v6'd and go nene.
Yeah. Let me see where they are.
Yep.
How are you guys going?
We're on the way. Fucking right, got a gun for all four of us are gonna be strapped up.
Alright, easy. Alright, I'm gonna start heading there now. I'm going up fucking Bay Tree Canyon.
Alright, sounds good.
Fuck, I don't even remember how to get to the fucking thing. Ugh. I'm pretty sure I just keep going straight. Fuck it. I'll work it out.
You just keep going straight and then you take a left onto Marlow Drive.
Yeah. And a Marlow?
What, the observatory?
No, sorry. Fucking East Galileo Avenue.
Yeah, and you keep going all the way up. Yeah.
Yeah.
Alright. Just don't get spotted. Keep chill.
Sounds good.
Alright, thank you. Goodbye.
Alright, bye-bye. Good luck.
I marked it. This observatory.
Wait, why is the sign behind?
Because I think you're thinking about going to a different place. No, that's the observatory.
That's not the observatory. The observatory is up here. You clown. That's a Vinewood Bowl.
Oh, shit, yeah. I'm cooked too. Shut up. I'm cooked as well, man.
Bruh. I was trying to send me in the fucking wrong direction.
Maybe I'm just trying to buy you some time or something. I don't fucking know.
Laying
our death.
Fuck it. Over the hill we go. We fucking mountain goat and shit. Vroom. Ooh. Oh, I almost fucking died. Holy shit.
We about got fucking wiped out right there.
Yeah, almost got taken out by a fucking local. Hello.
Hello.
Hi. Yo. Yo, what up, Reggie?
Good,
oh,
Reggie.
You know, I almost got taken out by a fucking local just then. It was great times. Living my best life, living my dream. Tired as fuck, but here I am. Alright, so wanted to reach out.
For making it.
You're all good. Wanted to reach out and have a chat about everything that's fucking happening and see if we can sort this shit out. Because I woke up today, got told everything, and by the looks of it, she's just escalating back and forth further and further. And honestly, from what it started from and that kind of stuff, I think that it should just be wrapped up and not continue backwards and forwards for a long ass time. But I wanted to talk with you guys, see what you guys are looking at with it, where it's at. So from what I've been told, between both sides now, because Future's spoken to me as well, was Fiona got rolled up on a money run. Didn't claim to be a part of anyone, and Future robbed her. Now, the reason, the whole thing with the robbing of it is kind of irrelevant to me. Yes, it was the start of it, but, you know, money runs happen, shit happens on money runs. And then from there, the boys rolled out and bit back, right? So it seemed like a bit of tit for tat for me on that. And then it kind of leaves it in your guys' court on what you want to do from there. You guys responded again from there. Several people got shot from what I've been told. And then we responded back again today by robbing a pusher, I think it was, is what Future said. So I'm just trying to see where this lies for you guys, what's going to happen, what the future is, if it's continuing, if it's not continuing, like, where's your guys' heads at with it?
I mean, I don't appreciate Benji throwing out war.
War?
I think that's like my biggest thing. Yeah, apparently it came out of his mouth when he when Jack got shot down. The
okay.
Words war were thrown out, so I don't really take light to it.
Oh, I honestly don't blame you for that. Right. I don't know if it might have been a heat of the moment kind of deal. I can have a chat and find out a little bit more about that. I can't answer for Benji at the moment. We don't want this escalating into a war. Here's the thing, right? Whilst what we're doing is still very new, going out and warring and that kind of stuff isn't really in anyone's best interest, right? Because we don't even have a fucking name yet.
Yeah, but at some point he's got to learn not to throw that word out, right? Like, you know, if I just went around throwing out war every time and I started getting shot down, I mean, that's on me.
Yeah, well, like I said, I can't really answer for him, right? Because I don't know about it or the context of when he said it. It was just a heat thing that he's just slipped up and said that instead of saying we're like in a shootout or something like that now. I can't really answer for that. I can have a chat to him, though, like I said, but I can't really answer too much for that. And I agree, the word bore shouldn't really be something that gets thrown around lightly.
How do you want to fix it then?
Well, that's what I'm talking to you guys about, right? Is essentially the way I see it is Fiona got robbed. Future said, if you want to do anything, run your money through Ming and Fanny. Now, we used to have a deal with you guys on the farmer side of stuff where we used to run through you guys. However, in doing that, the people at Sandy still got robbed all the time from you guys too. So there was never any kind of us wanting to get a get back or anything like that. But eventually, you know, it's going to come to a point where at one point there's going to be something that comes back from it, right? This is a please just leave us alone kind of deal, right?
Let me ask you a question, though. Like, who is in Sandy? Because from what I know, there's a lot of crews selling in Sandy, not just you guys. So Who runs Shandy?
Kaja. Same person that's always been doing it.
That group we ran into yesterday.
I've run into two different groups that sell that I end up part of you guys.
Okay, yeah, but your question was who runs Sandy, and that's KJ that runs it, right? Other people might push there and that kind of shit. They just do their thing, but we don't really deal with them, right? Not our problem.
But that's what I'm saying, though. When you say we robbed Sandy, that's what I'm trying to tell you. There's different groups that sell. They're not just you guys.
I'm talking about our guys. That's specifically what I'm talking about. I'm not talking about other people. A lot of the times it came back to me that they've been robbed from the besties and that kind of shit, right? We didn't go out looking for blood or anything like that. We just left shit be. Essentially, we just want to do it, so we're doing our thing. Now, the money run stuff, I honestly couldn't give a fuck, right? If people get robbed on a money run, they get robbed on a money run. You guys are wanting to hold that down and do your thing, yeah? I couldn't give two flying fucks about that shit. But, that's not something that we're looking at getting into. We're not looking at doing money runs. If they do a money run here and there, it's just to do it because they're bored. They want a little bit of spice in their life, right? Chase from PD or something like that. In actual fact, for the money runs, we're already going through Hydra. Just because I don't want to fucking deal with the headache that comes from that shit.
Yeah, but the thing is, right, you say you don't care about the money runs, which is fine. But then your crew acts differently, right? Like, Benji calls up Future, he says, Future asks him, if I don't give their stuff back, we call. And he's like, yeah, nothing's going to happen. Calls him on the phone. Next minute, he rolls out on him screaming war. Like, you say one thing, but your crew is a different thing. You see, that's the problem.
Do you have more context on that? The war bit? Sorry. You can go on.
That's a Jack question.
Oh, no. Yeah, I don't know anything. I'm sorry.
No, what you're saying. You're right.
Oh, no, I was just, I mean, I wasn't really part of this, but just from what I gather as an outsider, sort of, it seems like the problem lied in the first retaliation from you guys rather than the first robbery. Because I think, as you said, like, money runners get robbed, whatever, you don't really care. But it's the first retaliation because of the first robbery that started this whole back and forth thing.
Yeah. Yeah. To answer on that, to me, it's more of a tit for tat, right? Someone robs me for something, I end up going after them. I don't expect it to push more, but like Ming said, I understand why it got pushed more because of the word war that got thrown out. I 100% understand that, right? I still need to get some more context on it to see what like the moment was that it was said. Like if he calls you up and saying that's it, it's war, I get it, right? What I'm saying is kind of fucking irrelevant. But do you have a little bit more context on it, Jack?
Yeah, he picked me up and then he was talking to those boys on the radio saying, well, if we at war, then yada, yada, yada.
Okay.
So,
but no one had actually gone out and said, that's it, we're at war kind of stuff to you guys or you guys inside.
Throwing it out, you know? So,
yeah, I think he might have just slipped back into his old ways and thrown out the word like it used to be. I don't think anyone wants that at the moment.
I think it's more the 180 he did, right? He went from, nah, we're not going to do anything to them throwing out, you know, we're at war. It's the 180, you know what I mean?
Yeah. Well. Okay. I'm going to have a chat to him and find out about it. If he's saying it on the radio, I don't think he means it to tell you guys we're at war kind of deal, talking from knowing Benji long enough. But again, I get where you're coming from with the word war coming out, right? But don't think that I don't understand what you're saying there. I still need to talk to him and find out his context for it. But from what I'm looking at the moment, you guys got a lick from Fiona. They came back, bit back. You guys shot more of them yesterday. And today, according to Future, they robbed one of them.
So where they robbed multiple times,
I haven't heard anything from the other boys. To my knowledge, the only person that got robbed from one of the boys that was awake was Pred, is one of your pushers. Other than that, no one else has done anything except for Jamal, who kept trying to run at them at the house with a fucking wrench, and he got dealt with
Oh, Jamal's just our pet.
Yeah, Jamal does Jamal things.
So you're saying Kyle Pred got robbed?
Yeah, that's the only person that got robbed yesterday. That's it. That's from one of the boys that was awake yesterday. Well, today, sorry. Earlier. So other than that, you guys shot Zulu, Mike, and Maxine yesterday. Just wanting to know, like, from your guys' side, like, what's the end? Like, what are we looking at? Because I think this has been tit for tat, and...
Hey, let us speak for a sec, all right?
Hey, you're good. You want us to walk away? No, you're good.
No, we'll go for
it. Fuck. I wish you would have said... I mean, let's be honest, you guys have been up there for a fucking month, running everybody's package. Like, eventually somebody's gonna fucking, you know, get tired of it. Like,
yeah.
you know what it is.
I spoke about it a bit. But I said eventually someone's gonna bite back, right? So I'm not here to fucking try and dick people or fucking anything like that.
I get it.
We've got more pressing things to deal with.
So, they're saying that Benji said war with the radio?
Yeah.
I just Benji being gassed up.
That's the way I say it. Heat of the moment.
All him just yelling over the radio, fucking adrenaline going all crazy, saying, whoa!
Yeah.
You think they're going to want a money offer?
I don't know. I think it's just been tit for tat. It just needs to stop, to be honest.
I mean, it's not going nowhere. It's not doing shit.
Yeah, it's not beneficial for anyone involved.
Fucking
Cody. He's actually an idiot.
He's actually so fucking stupid.
There's only five of them, so they've got a six somewhere. I wonder if it's Poe. You're still on the yellow pages? The poll will be posted up somewhere. If it was going to be anywhere, it'd be on the hill line. And you could sit on the roof. The roof's kind of an amp position on this place. But if you'd be anywhere, you'd be watching from the top. Gary. Hello.
Hi.
You're having boy talk.
Oh, I'm Brandon, good. By the way. Nice to formally meet you.
Oh, I'm Fanny. It's nice to meet you too.
Thanks. Hello. I'm Reggie.
You're Reggie?
Yep, that's me.
Nice Yapa. To meet you.
Nice to meet you too.
Well, what's you guys' group? Were you guys with the company before it exploded?
I was the company's downfall. I was there for a week and took that some bitch down. Fuck the company.
Yep. And I was really? There beside him, yeah, holding the detonator for the C4.
Yeah, fuck. Fuck the company.
Fuck the company.
Bunch of bums.
Yeah, fuck the company.
Yeah, we never liked them.
I didn't really know about it, but fuck the company.
Yeah, I'm just happy I was part of their downfall. Hide me for a fucking week. Gone.
Do you guys have a group name yet?
No, that's what I'm saying. Like, there's other things that we should be doing instead of having a back and forth with anyone else right now.
Yeah. And you guys should come up with like a gang sign.
Oh, please no. Please no.
Do you want to see ours?
What is it?
Yeah, let's see it.
Besties slay.
Oh shit, that's pretty good.
Okay.
You like it?
It's not bad.
Listen, at least it's not an actual typical gang sign.
What?
You're Uncle T's guy, no?
I'm Uncle T's friend. Look, let me sort that out, because you guys have been running up saying that. I think my man over here pointed a gun at me in the middle of the street of Legion, asking me to keep your name out of Uncle T's mouth or something. I don't know. So me and T have been friends for a long time. Yeah, me and him were rolling together for a while. And then he moved off to other places. So did I. That's where that ends. So
he watched me at a Vanilla Unicorn on my first day in the city. I was a stripper for a day, and he was there. He was one of my three customers.
That sounds like Uncle T. Yeah,
definitely sounds like his thing.
More flaccid.
Oh,
well, that's.
Well, I mean, he's getting up there in age, though. You know what I mean? So
he probably didn't have his Viagra or something.
Yeah,
shit don't work the same anymore when you're that old.
Boy.
So, all right. What do you guys get up to in the city?
Some big dog.
Sorry.
We're going to need some compensation, you know what I'm saying?
Right.
You know my dog Kyle Pett got robbed? That's my slime.
Huh?
My blog got robbed, the wigwam.
Wigwam.
Jack got robbed. Jamal got robbed.
What'd Jamal get robbed of?
I mean, did you say y'all shot him down or what? Is that what you said?
I mean, he come at him with a fucking wrench, like.
Okay, so I'm assuming y'all robbed him, no?
I would doubt, honestly, to be honest, if I'm coming at someone with a fucking wrench, knowing what could happen from it, I ain't carrying shit on me, right?
I'm also gonna be honest, I don't think Jamal has anything to rob.
I think Jamal's kind of floating around until the casino opens, to be honest. Loves that place.
God fucking help him on that.
You know, let's just call it 50k.
50k. 50k is what we're throwing out after 21k lick already. And then you all shot three people.
Next time, tell your people to claim their set.
We don't have a set yet to claim, right? Listen, I'm not going to argue about the war shit, right? I 100% understand where you're coming from.
My problem is the fact that your person didn't claim anything, didn't say anything. Then Benji on the phone says he's not going to do anything about it. The next one is coming out fucking war running out in free cars. See what I'm saying?
Yeah.
But this would be way different if on the phone he would have said, okay, I'm not happy with this, I'm doing this. On the phone, he's like, no, we ain't doing nothing about it. Then he rolls out screaming war.
Huh?
That's the issue.
Wait, can I sidebar really quick? Forehead. Please. Okay.
Look, I'm biting my fucking tongue here. I about said, you guys have been robbing pushes up there for a month.
Relax.
You guys are talking about cop.
Let me handle it.
He ain't giving him 50k, Reggie. That's absurd.
Relax.
I'm sorry.
You're good.
No, you're fine.
Yeah, that's pretty much it.
So just back to what I was saying, right? Is you guys are wanting 50k, you guys got a 21k lick, you guys shot down three people, which no doubt you would have robbed as well, right? And you guys have also been pressing the pushes and Sandy for quite a while as well. There's been nothing that's come back from it. Now, I get it. You said they didn't rep their set. We don't have a set yet to be repped, right? We're literally in the startup phase. There ain't no set to be standing there saying, this is our group name or anything like that. Yeah. So I can also understand why she wouldn't do that.
I always said like, oh, I'm with Forehead and Ming. Those are my friends.
Yeah. Not even that. I asked her who she's running her money for, and she said myself. But Benji said it was for him.
Yeah.
Why didn't she just say it was for Benji then?
To be fair, though, even if it was that, like I said earlier, if it was me in your position, I still would have robbed them because that's your business you guys do, right? Which is running money running and cleaning people's shit. So I could have understood where even if she did say that, running her pocket still would have been a thing, right? Because that's your guys' thing. If I mean, I'm doing something as my thing.
She might have got robbed.
Yeah, you know, let's speak about what actually happened.
I still look at hypotheticals on those things, on the reality of what that hypothetical could have been. Because you're coming at saying...
It wasn't. Let's speak off base off facts.
It's a hypothetical for a reason, because it never happened.
It's still a valid hypothetical, though.
I would rather go with things that actually happened, though. You know what I mean?
Okay, so I run it back. Had she said that she's running for Benji, and then still got robbed and something came from that, would still be at the same position, no?
But that never happened. We don't know what would have happened because it never happened. That scenario never erased itself, so we don't know.
Okay. So even with all the back and forth that's happened, you're still looking at 50k.
I think 50k is pretty generous, to be honest.
Well. I have to talk to our people. I don't know how happy people are going to be to want to pay shit, to be honest, after people have been shot as well. But I'll still take it back and I'll talk to them and see if we can come to some kind of mutual agreement for this and put this shit behind us.
I mean, y'all could probably just sell some OTT shit and get some money out of it, right?
Say again?
You could probably just sell some OTT shit what you took and, you know, pay us for that.
What shit do we take of OTTs?
No,
because I've heard this narrative before and I've already pushed it right to people. So essentially what was taken from OTT is 75% of everything.
It's none of my business.
Okay, well, I mean, you're saying it, that's why I'm trying to clear it up, because OTT got his fair share. If he tells you any different, that's on him, man. Well, I'll go and have a chat with them when they wake up tomorrow. Now we'll see during the time of while I'm talking to them. What are you guys doing? Are you still hunting people? Are you not hunting?
Who knows?
Hypotheticals, right?
Yeah.
Well, what's hypothetical about it? Either you're going to do it or you're not. That's what I want to know.
Maybe, you know, maybe I go to Senior Buns, eat some food, and I get real full, and I maybe go take a nap, or maybe, you know, who knows what I'm going to do.
People, and then we'll come back.
Right. Okay. So essentially, everything's still staying as is, I'm guessing, until then. That's the way I'm going to take it from this. And once I talk to Benji and the rest of them, I'll come back to you guys, and we'll see where we land from there.
I mean, if you really cared about Sandy, you didn't want them getting robbed constantly, and maybe your people that you're affiliated with, you know, not getting robbed constantly, getting shot, I feel like 50K is pretty fair, no?
So 50K stops the people and Sandy getting robbed as well. How long?
For your people. I mean, I don't know whose stuff that really is, you know? Is it Chaos Legion stuff? I had some other crew named Octane running it. So maybe, you know, your people, your side of the turf, I guess, your section of it is safe of it, yeah.
Okay, for how long, though? That's what I'm saying. Is it like a week thing and then you guys will run their pockets again? What are we looking at?
He should be good.
All right. I'll have a chat. We'll get back to you tomorrow.
Okay.
I'll see you later.
It was nice to meet you guys. See,
you too.
Yeah, you too. See you guys later. It's the second time we about got hit by a car.
Yeah.
Just crazy, man. It's just crazy.
I'm hungry again. You got food?
I got a hot dog for you in the thing. What's up?
Actually, I had one in my pockets the whole time, and here I am fucking starving. Okay.
So, I'm gonna be honest. That just makes me want to spend my whole bank account on guns and just shoot them. Constantly.
We've got more important things to be dealing with, to be honest.
It's not my shit to deal with.
Oh, yes.
I mean, kind of is, in a way, but... This is Brandon. What? Yeah, I mean, we're traveling. We're being followed still, but I think we're just all going to the city. Yeah. Where you want him to go, Reg?
Probably could go to Mirror Park Dam.
I go to the Mirror Park Dam. Yeah, you're very quiet on the phone, by the way, Khalid. I let him.
Yeah, I know what Benji's already gonna say. I already know Benji's response. Thanks for staying up. No worries.
It's gonna be fuck you.
Listen, why couldn't I have just been shot so I don't even have to fucking talk to Mike? Honestly.
Yeah, we gotta talk to him.
Honestly, why couldn't I have just been shot there so I didn't have to talk to Mike? That would have made me fucking happy. That would have made my fucking night.
And Mike's on the phone.
Fuck Mike. Fucking yapper.
Yeah, but I want you to have this conversation with me. And I need you to, like...
50K, that still happened, yeah. Yeah, that's why Reggie said it.
Like, I want to check his temperature, see if he's still down for the cause or what.
Yeah, we haven't really fucking lost fuck all there, so, you know. Just remember, guys, always make sure you guys are being kind and being nice.
As always.
I ain't pressed. The only thing I'm pressed about is not going to sleep already. That's it. Other than that, I'm Gucci, man. I'm Gucci. I'm never get fucking angry over this shit.
See, I told you nobody shoots during meetings. It's an unspoken agreement.
I have seen Benji drop a fucking pipe bomb at someone's feet during a meeting, so I don't want to hear that.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Where was that at?
Right at the same place that we... right back there. Yep. Also at the Vinewood Bowl.
Oh, so,
Benji with the fucking pipe bomb's always dangerous.
I'm trying to think of, like, you know, who he would have done that to. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Just, I can't think of anybody, to be honest.
Fucking hell. Nicole, thank you for the 10 bomb! Sorry if I'm not answering some of you guys. Try not to go off into the fucking water. Or Pred.